What up, y'all? Oh, there he is. This little man wrapping it up right there, watching Daddy work. So right now I'm putting the pins together and trying to find the proper placement that I want to do. He's chewing on some sticks. But we are getting the pins set up right now, and I want to see the size I'm working with. I know it's a pretty decent size, but with the layout of everything I got going on, I want to have two of them joined together for the chickens, the ducks, and that way I can extend a whole big play area to see what I'm working with. It's going to be good times, y'all. Alrighty. Who says you can't put a whole pen together by yourself? All you need is a couple good logs to hold one of your pen panels upright, and you're good to go. I got my first 10x10 pen up, and it's going to be ready for the chicks and ducks. I just got to put the top on. Another beautiful day in the mountain. Little Ghost is joining us. So I've got these cattle panels, and I am setting up and trying to find a good placement for my Cooney Cooney habitat. So we're going to go ahead and get that set up. I've got six panels, and we're fixing to move over the animal housing and get the piglets over here. Excited about that, y'all. So yesterday I constructed the pen for the pigs, and I'm going to add more fencing today, bring that over. And I'm going to construct a new house for the chicks and bring them all over today, transition them over, and then hopefully take down the other pen like that and bring that over. So I'm trying to get all my animals over here as quick as possible. What up, what up? It's chicken coop building time, guys. Basically what I've done so far, I just constructed this frame out of 2x4s. It's a 4x8, and it's gonna sit inside my pen, and I'm gonna use these 4x4s for posts, level those out, go from there. Now we got our 4x4 post, 6 foot for that particular corner. Reason why I'm leveling it out, because I've got uneven ground and we're building in the woods, y'all. Okay, so I got the 4x4 post attached. I got it off the ground 17 inches, which is about a foot and a half. I wanted to maximize the whole run for the chicks so they could go in and out. Now we're gonna put the side paneling on. I did have two of these, but I did have to get another one. They're only 25 bucks a piece. Ghost, are you in Daddy's box? We're gonna have to shut that lid. So I just took one of the 4x8 sheets and I ripped it and I cut it right in half, and that's gonna be one of the side pieces. Hey, little ghost, are you cut up? Here's my little help. I'll get you done. All right, y'all, I got the side walls on and I got the back wall on. What I'm gonna go ahead and do now is I'm gonna do the flooring, and then we're gonna go ahead and frame out for the door. Once I set it back in place, they'll have a little bit more room opened up. But also, this whole area right here, there's the pig panels. I'm gonna frame out, put out their structure, and I'm gonna fence in all this area around here for one big common area for them to free range. Let's go, buddy. So I had some leftover material from an old build, which I used for the flooring. Now, I was a little short on the sides, but I had some dog ear picket fences that I used to fill in. So I did that with the other side and the back of this as well. So now we just gotta put the roof on and frame out the door and put the front end on. Time got away from me last night. I wanted to start a little bit earlier, but we had some rains today, but slightly overcast now, but we are clear skies for the next week, which I'm pretty stoked about because we need to get all the animals over here. So basically what I'm doing is I'm framing out the door now, and I'm gonna do a 4x4 door on that side, and I'm gonna do a little hatch entrance exit right there, and getting ready to frame out the door and get that set up. All right, I've got it completely framed out. What I did was use 2x3s, and I'm gonna use two hinges and a nice level latch to open up the door nice and easy. All right, y'all, I got the latch and the two hinges on for the main door, and we're gonna go ahead and do the second door with a little hatch. So right now, I'm working on door number two, so I have another big opening to collect eggs and things of that nature. And I'm constructing out a little hatch door that's gonna flip right up for the chicks to come out first thing in the morning. All right, so here's my framed out big door. It's gonna get a latch right here. And this is the little hatch right here. So then they wake up in the morning, just let the chicks out and put them back in. Quick, nice and easy. All right, y'all, let's hang the door. All right, y'all, let me give you a quick little tour with the camera still like this, because otherwise it's just way too close. So basically, I got a little ramp set up. I've got a 4'4" door for clean out, the latch and hatch. Plenty of room inside right there on their roost. Got another door over here where I've got their nesting boxes, and it's got a ramp right up. And then I got a little hatch so they can come out in the mornings and stay open. Just for easy access, y'all. Let me give you a little bit more tour. All right, y'all, there she is, 4x8. It's got about 1.5 feet of clearance for them to run around. They're in a 10x10 pen that I have set up here that I got from Tractor Supply. I've got a 4x4 door with a latch for easy clean out. I got the roosting bars. I got to add another roosting bar in there. Got another door for easy access and clean out, and their nesting boxes. Mine like them low. I got Brahmas and Lavender Orpingtons, so they're big hens. So they need a little bit of room, but this is what works for me. Then I got their little hatch door, so they could come in and out throughout the day as they please with their little ladder ramp. Put them in at night, shut them up, say goodnight. That's pretty much a wrap for the chicken coop, y'all. That's how I do it. So I've been in that good transition period where I've been going from the new homestead to the old homestead to take care of the chicks, ducks, and pigs. But I needed to get things set up in place here. But I'm good to go now, so it's time to transition over the chicks and ducks, and the pigs will be coming. Everybody will be coming this weekend, so I'm excited about that. Next time you see it, we'll have the chicks and ducks inside. Well, at least just the chickens. I got another one that I'm building. Just putting up the pen for the ducks, and I've already got the duck house, and I just need to finish putting up the pig structure, the habitat, and the fun run for everybody to free range. So good times coming, y'all. All right, they're super leery about this setup. I would be too. Come on, guys. All right, we're gonna have to do this another way. So one by one we go. So we did this one at a time, but we got them all in there. You guys ready? Promise it'll be a smooth drive.
Doesn't even care. She's just happy with her banana.
Hey, Shane. Go, baby. Girl. All right, y'all. Chicks and ducks are over. I'm joined by Jenna.
Hello.
And Chris, Flower Town Charm. And we got little Moonshine all loaded up in the truck. Got their home. And my little co-pilot's gonna be Whiskey. Don't pee all over my seat, little man. Yeah. You're such a good boy.
Hi, Moonshine. Yeah. You going to your new home?
Well, so it's, I don't even know if that thing can live outside, you know?
Hi, honey.
Yeah, I'll be coming inside. Yeah, I don't know.
stealing him. He's mine now.
Isn't he the sweetest?
Yes. You smell like puppy and I love you.
They are all home. Got them moved and settled with the help of my good friends Chris and Jenna. Hey guys, you guys happy? Got them a good amount of space in here. I'm going to open it up for free range and more. And this is going to be opened up wider in the back down the road as I expand. All the chicks and ducks. Now I just need to put the pens up for the ducks and we'll get them moved over in due time. Probably this weekend.